Stock market volatility. We've seen a lot lately, and it's not likely to go away for some time. But that doesn't mean you should be escaping if you're an ETF investor. We have Saum Seif, the president of Claymore Investments, here back to explain. Welcome back, Saum.
Good to be here.
So you were telling me, you figure when we're about 12% down as we speak, and you don't see us getting much further down in volatility.
Well, I think the volatility is going to remain, as you said in the outset. I think we're going to see a very volatile period here. Remember, we've got a lot of things to worry about, whether it's the European crisis, whether it's the sovereign debt crisis and GDP debt to GDP ratios you're seeing in the major developed countries, or even just the jobless rates you're seeing here in North America. You know, these are major issues, and we've got to solve them. So volatility will be here for some time. And what we're finding right now, we've seen a market correction here. We're likely sort of call it 12-13% off the peaks. And remember, that's a corrective state. You know, do I think we're going to see, you know, another 10-20% down? No. I think we'll probably see some slight movement downwards, but we'll start to see buying. There's a lot of cash on the sidelines, some buying that'll come back in the marketplace because of the discounts you're seeing in the markets today.
Okay, so you have one approach, which is fundamental indexing, because you're affiliated with Rob Arnott's research affiliates.
Right.
How does fundamental index-based ETFs help smooth volatility?
Well, I think the key thing with what RAFI, or fundamental indexing, does, which we use for our core equity products in Canada, U.S., and international, is it basically looks at companies based on their fundamentals and weights companies based on their fundamentals. And it doesn't get caught up into the price weighting or the market cap weighting that the traditional S&P TSX 60 or the S&P 500 has. So the issues at Nortel and some of the, you know, the RIMS and the material companies that we saw last couple of years, where you really overweight overvalued companies quite aggressively. So it really avoids some of that. And what it does is it really picks better companies that are going to be selected and weighted for the long run on a better basis. So what RAFI is really good at is providing you a great long-term equity exposure without the same levels of risk the market provides.
So you see a RAFI fundamental index ETFs complementing dividend ETFs.
Well, we think that if you're a core equity investor, we think RAFI represents the best way to get that core equity exposure. If you're looking at the current environment, another way to look at investing is dividend investing. So they complement each other very well. But dividends, if you look at a sort of volatile environment or a sideways type environment, which I think we're going to see in the short term here, I would look at dividend investing. We have two ETFs, a Canadian dividend ETF and a global dividend ETF, that really do a great job of giving you exposure to high income. And in a sideways market, income does a great job of providing you with some good returns. So those are sort of what I would be looking at in this type of environment as a very critical way to invest in the equity markets.
So presumably the Canadian dividend one is non-registered for tax reasons, and the global dividend one is an RSP or
Well, TSA. Actually, in fact, we have both of them as being very tax efficient. Our Canadian dividend spits out dividend income, just so for a Canadian investor. And our global dividend, what we've done is we've actually put a tax forward structure around it so that all the income comes as return of capital or ROC. So that foreign investing in dividends is very difficult, is very challenging in terms of the tax inefficiency. What we've done is we've made it very tax efficient. So as an income investor, you can now get diversified global dividend exposure between these two vehicles.
So even non-registered, the global income would be relatively tax efficient.
That's right.
That's good. And the third major element is emerging markets that you think is a core equity in these volatile markets. You surprised me in our pre-interview by saying you actually thought the BRIC ETF is safer than your broader emerging markets ETF. I always thought it would have been the other way around.
Well, I think there's to explain exactly why I think emerging markets is important, you look at the developed nations. We're going to see very stunted growth in the developed nations, especially when you look at debt to GDP ratios and the economic situations in many of these major Europe, Asia, North America. So where's the growth going to come economically? It's going to come from the countries that have lower debt to GDP ratios, China, Brazil. These emerging countries have a very low debt to GDP ratios. They're growing quite dramatically. They're very important markets if you look at growth. So I wouldn't be putting 50% of my equity portfolio in these markets, but I would be looking at them as a component to get the growth aspect of my portfolio. The reason I think the BRICS, being Brazil, Russia, India, and China, are very important is because these countries are a little bit more developed beyond just broader emergings. We know that China and India and Brazil are really important economically to the global trade and global economic environment. And they're, I think, on the bridge right now between going from emerging to developed over the next 5 to 7 years. So I think of them as actually a little bit more developed than they are just emerging. And then you look at around about, we have our BRIC product, we also have a broader emerging markets ETF that gives you the other countries, the countries that are still to be determined, but they're high growth environments, and then really I think represent a good place to put some money in a small percentage of your portfolio.
So as far as your emerging markets, you'd put maybe half of it in the BRIC and the other half in the broad emerging markets.
I think that's an interesting strategy to go with for the future.
Excellent. Thank you very much, Sam Seif, the president of Claymore Investments in Toronto.
Great to be here.